welcome to my second barre video. My name's Kyla and I'll be teaching a barre class today. So we'll start the class with a warm-up to get into our bodies, some plank work, then we'll move into our arms with some push-ups, some weights, or for me, wine bottles. If you have legit weights, great. If you don't, wine bottles work. Water bottles, literally whatever you want or nothing, it's up to you. And then after arms, we'll move into our legs. And we'll start on the mat, and then as we stand up, you can use anything to balance. Today I have my Swiffer to balance me, pretty useful. And then we'll move into some glute work, again using the Swiffer or whatever you have to balance you. And then we'll do abs, and then we'll stretch. And just like the previous video, if you're able to and would like to, consider sending money to my Venmo at Dancer Kyla. If you have any questions, feel free to DM me also on Instagram at Dancer Kyla. Let's get started. All right, y'all, let's get warmed up. We'll start in a parallel position. Feet right underneath your hips. Relax your shoulders down your back. And let's start with a head roll. To start with these, just to check in with your body. Allowing yourself to pause anywhere you need to pause. Breathing into it, and reverse directions. Allow your feet to feel really stable into the floor, and breathe. We'll roll our shoulders back and down. Notice how there's some softness in my knees. I'm allowing them to bend and extend. Reverse directions, four, three, two, and reach your hands above your head. You'll find a flat back. Lengthen your spine as long as you can, pulling your navel in towards your spine. And release. Bend your knees, roll up to standing. We'll find this three more times. Let it feel good. Your knees can stay soft. Whatever you need to get into your spine, your core, and your legs. Roll up. Two more. Reach. Release over and roll up. Last one. Reach. And release. Stay folded forward. Nod your head. Yes. Shaking up. That yes. Shaking up. And soften your knees a little more to roll yourself up to standing. We'll get into some fuller movement. I'll face you, staying in our parallel position. You'll find a squat and lift. Down and press. Make sure your knees are tracking over your toes. Your weight is in your heels. You're sticking your booty back behind you. Back and lift. Back. Using energy in your fingertips. Relaxing your shoulders down your back. And as always, we're breathing. We'll add a knee lift every time we extend our legs. You'll squat down, lift, down, lift. Good. See if you can use your low core to lift your knee up, down, lift. Let's find four more. Three, two, and one. You'll step out to one side, side lunge, lift. And step other side, and lift up to tempo. Lunge, lift. Pulling your navel in towards your spine. Keep breathing, out, lift, good y'all. For four, three, two, hold your lunge, reach your arms to the side, shift one side. Shift, shift. Almost there. Keep pulling your navel in, reaching energy out of both ends of your spine and your fingertips. For four, three, two, and one. Stand at the back of your mat. Drop your head. Roll down. Walk your hands to the top of your mat. Feet to the back, plank position. Inhale, lift your right leg up to a three-legged dog. And exhale, right knee to left elbow. Inhale, lift. And exhale, in. Let's speed it up right here. You'll lift and in. Lift. Going at whatever tempo feels best for you. Keep breathing. Lift and lower. This is it for four, three, two, and one. Hold your plank for eight, six, four, three. Lift your left leg up, left knee to right elbow, and lift, same, and lift up to tempo. Press and lift, down, lift. Almost there. Really finding your abs. Really breathing, pressing through your hands. Four more for four, three, two, and one. Hold your plank for eight, six, four, three, two. Lower down to your forearms. Keep your plank. Bend alternating knees. Right, left. You got this. Breathe. Almost there. We have one more change for plank. In eight, six, four, three, two. Hold your plank. You'll tuck, release. Tuck. Tuck. Really firing up your low abdominals. Breathing as you move. Woo! And tuck. For four, three, two, and one. Knees down. Child's pose. Take a breath. All right, y'all. Moving into some push-ups. Find your hands. You can tuck your toes for full push-ups or drop your knees, heels towards your glutes. You'll find down, two, three, and press. Two, three, and press. Down, two, three. Two more like this. Down, two, three. Last one. Eight push-ups up to tempo. You have eight. This is seven. Breathe, six. Two more, two, and one. Press your hips back, keep them lifted. Press your chest towards the mat. Breathe. Moving on from our warm up to arms, let's find a standing position. We'll start with shoulders. I'm not gonna use weights for this, but you absolutely can. It's up to you. We'll find a parallel position once again. Arms in a goalpost. You'll press up and pull down. Press, pull. I want both directions to have equal importance. So actively pressing up and actively pulling down. Good. We'll add a little balance work to this. You'll extend one leg out in front of you. As you press up, lift your leg up and lower. Lift, lower. Using your low abs to help you out. I don't care about the height of the leg. I'm more focused about the balance and then obviously your shoulders. You have three, two. Keep your leg lifted. Arms hold the goalpost, low pulse up. Lift, lift. Keep pulling your navel in towards your spine, finding support there. Really breathing. Press. Press. You'll notice where your balance is on your feet, so a little itch. You'll tend to go over to one side of the arch or the other. I usually go over to my outer arch, so I have to actually press down through my full foot to stabilize, keeping your base knee bent. You have eight, six, four, three, two, foot in. You'll rotate your arms 90 degrees, lift, rotate. Like a little robot, or marionette, whatever you want. Extend your other leg out in front of you, bending your base leg, lift your leg up and lower, lift. Again, I don't care about height. You're on, you know, you're in your own space. So if you want to fly your leg up to your face, that's completely up to you. But I'll be floating here at this 45 degree angle for four, three, two. Keep your leg lifted. Circle your arms back. Little circle, circle, circle. Stabilizing through your base leg. Pulling your navel in towards your spine. Relax your shoulder blades down your back and breathe. We've got this. Circle, circle, circle. Woo! For eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, and down. You'll cross your arms in front and cross. Open. As you cross in front, find a little squeeze in your chest. And then as you open up, feel a little squeeze in your mid-back. Try to keep your ribcage closed as you open your arms. So without going like this, although it's fun and cute, we're focusing here. We'll add a releve, lifting our heels. In, lift up. In, lift. Releve is optional. Breathe as you move. Pressing through the balls of your feet. Woo! I don't know about you, but even without weights, my shoulders are burning. Front and open. For four, three, two. Keep your heels lifted. Reach your arms to the side. Little circle back, back. Really similar to last class. You've got it for eight, six, four, three. Reverse the circle. We're almost done. I promise this is it. Breathing really helps. For eight, six, four, three, two, and release. Shake it off. Grab your weights if you don't already have them. For me, these little guys. Finding a wide stance, heels in, toes and knees out, wider than your hips. Your palms are up. Extend your arms, full bicep curl, and extend. Curl, extend. Really resist the curl. Squeeze your biceps. Breathe as you move. We'll add a plie and lift. Plie and lift. Make sure your knees are pressing out over your toes. And you're breathing. Can't say it enough, y'all. Curl, extend. Curl. Breathe, shoulders over your hips. For four, three, two. Hold your plie and your curl. Little curl, little curl. Option to add a pulse in your legs. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze your biceps. Drawing your shoulders back and down. Think about widening your collarbone. For eight, six, four, three, two. You'll rotate your arms out and front, out and front. Adding the extension of your legs once again. We'll do a lot of pulsing in our wide second. So I want to kind of refrain from that for right now, because we'll feel it later. Out and open. Keep your elbows in. For four, three, two. Hold your arms out and curl, extend. Curl, extend. Really resist. Keep going. I have a little itch on my bicep. Good. Curl, extend. Good. Breathe. Notice if your arms try to sneak forward and keep them out to the side. You have three, two, hold halfway, little squeeze. Option to press up to the balls of your feet for a little balance. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Squeeze your biceps. We're almost there. Triceps are next. For 8, 6, 4, 3, 2, and release. Give it a little shake. Still holding on to whatever your weights are. Grip is interesting for sure. Parallel stance. Bend your knees. Hinge your torso forward. Draw your elbows behind your spine. Extend long and bend. Reach. Reach. Squeeze your triceps behind you. Draw your shoulders down your back. Pull your navel in towards your spine. Good. We'll add a little alternating heel and heel. Alternate. Good. Breathe. Shoulders back and down. Your chin is away from your chest. For 4, 3, 2. Keep both heels lifted, arms long, little pulse up. Lift, lift, lift. Almost there. For 8, 6, 4, 3, 2, and release. Set your weights down. We'll pop down onto our mats. And move on to some more triceps, but on our hands and feet. Parallel feet. Hands are planted behind you, fingertips face forward. Draw your shoulders back and down. Press up. Favorite tricep dips. And press. Down. Press. You got this. Keep breathing. Keep your core strong. It's really easy to allow your shoulders to go up to your ears, but press away. Think lengthy swan neck instead of little turtle. For 4, 3, 2. You'll pulse down, down, press. Down, down, press. Down, down, press. Use your breath. That's my main phrase. Down, down, press. For 4, 3, 2. Last one, we'll go a little pulse. Woo! I feel it, y'all. You've got it. For 8, 7, 6, 5. And release. Give it a shake. Fold forward. All right. Let's find a little stretch. And then we'll move on to legs. Reaching one arm across. Shoulder down. Inhale. Exhale, maybe you head roll. Hand to shoulder. Grab your elbow, gently pull, lengthening one side. Maybe take a little peek. What a jam. All right, other side. Inhale, exhale again, maybe you head roll. All right, hand to shoulder, grab your elbow, gently pull. Maybe you take a peek. I wish I could sing like that. All right, last stretch. Hands behind your back, open your chest, and release forward. All right, y'all, let's move on. Okay, moving on to legs. The first exercise will be on our mat. So we'll come to our knees. Make sure your knees, everything is glued together. If anything like this bothers your knees, you can always come up to a standing position and do kind of the same thing. So once we get into it, I'll demonstrate that. So your legs are glued together. I like to bring my arms in front of me. It just feels really stabilizing. So draw your shoulders down and back. Find a little tuck in your tailbone and lift your hips up just a little bit and down. Lift, lower. It's really small. And just keep in mind, we won't be in this position for too long because it is really intense and gets into the quadriceps fairly quickly. So take your time, breathe through it, and just know it's not forever. For 4, 3, 2, keep your hips lifted, a little tuck forward, little tuck, tuck. Relax your shoulders. Keep breathing out. 8, 6. My booty is like just floating off of my heels. Not too high. Little tuck right to left. Right, left. Breath is strong. Keep breathing. Pulling your navel in towards your spine. You should feel your quads freaking burning. So keep going here if this feels fine. If this bothers your thighs, or your knees, excuse me, rewind, restart. You'll come to a parallel position, press up to the balls of your feet, bend your knees, sink your seat towards your heels, tuck, and then find a little pulse. And then you'll do the same thing. You'll stay low and tuck, and then tuck side to side. All right, we're still tucking right to left. I know y'all. For 8, 6, 4, we'll extend all the way up, all the way down. Lift up for 2, down for 2. Ooh, saving it. And down. Lift and lower. Lift and lower. Couple more. Lift and lower. Last one. Hold halfway and just breathe here. For 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and release. Shake it off. All right, next exercise. Come to standing. Grab your Swiffer or balancing object, chair, whatever you want. Set it in front of you or face it. You'll take a wide stance, heels in, toes, knees out wider than your hips. Bend your knees, sink your seat towards the floor, tuck your tailbone slightly under. We'll start with a full range plie, so really take up all that space, press, lower. Make sure you're pressing your knees back over your toes, similar to what we talked about when we were doing biceps. For 4, 3, 2, and hold low, little pulse. Feeling grounded, see if you can really let the backs of your legs lift up from underneath so you're getting out of the quadriceps, or not out of the quadriceps, out of the hip flexors, still in your quads. Let's exercise. Relax your shoulders down and back. Keep breathing, pulling your navel in. Down, lift. For 4, 3, 2, alternate, lift one heel, then the other. Lift. Lift. Good. You got this. Relax your shoulders. See if you can keep your elbows a little lifted, or if your hands are out in front of you on a chair, see if you can try to like avoid getting really like into yourself, but really lifting and lifting and engaging. For 4, 3, 2, both heels lift and lower. Lift, lower, lift, lower. Good. See if you can press your weight onto your big toes and second toes instead of letting your ankles sickle out behind you towards your pinky toes while your knees still press back. Little opposition work. For 2, keep your heels lifted. Extend your legs up for 2, down for 2. Press and lower. Press and lower. Really finding the length in your legs and breathe. Press and lower. Press and lower. Couple more. Press and lower. Last one. Hold low, wrap your knees back. A little press, 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 press. Make sure your knees don't really come forward at all. They're just pressing back from their already turned out
positions. You're feeling a little work in your glutes.
Press, press, press. For four, three, two, last change. Hold your balance. Maybe you let go of whatever you're holding on to or lift your balancing object up. For eight, six, four, three, two, and one. Shake it off. Let's find a little stretch before we move on into glutes. You'll step your left foot forward, press your right heel back. Inhale. Exhale. Shift your weight forward. Right ankle, right hand. Dive your right knee behind your left. Tuck your tailbone slightly under. Maybe you hinge forward. Release. Other side. Step your left heel back. Inhale. Exhale. Shift your weight forward. Left ankle, left hand. Dive your left knee behind your right. Tuck your tailbone slightly under. Maybe you hinge forward. Release. Shake it off. All right, let's move on to our booty. We'll start standing, balancing with this cute little Swiffer. So you'll face it, heels together, toes apart, feet in a small V. Bend your knees, tuck your tailbone slightly under. Extend one leg, I'll extend my right, but if I'm mirroring you, it might be your left. Retuck your tailbone under and lift your leg up and lower. You'll notice my leg is at a slight diagonal to the back. Keep tucking your tailbone. It's really easy to like lean forward and use our whatever balancing object you have to like hold your weight. But see if you can minimize that. It's just there to give you a little support, not to support your full body, especially the Swiffer. I feel like I shouldn't be doing that. He's not that strong. Lift, squeezing this little glute for four, three, two. Keep your leg lifted, little pulse up. Lift and lift. I'll give you another angle. Good. You can flex or point your foot. Per usual, I'm happy with either one. But as long as there's energy, as long as it's not just like a dead little foot on the edge of your leg. Really find energy there. Good. If you haven't already, flex your foot now. Bend your knee, heel to glute, and extend. Bend. And extend. Notice how the top part of my leg stays the same. Curl. You'll really feel your hamstrings. Two more times slow. Curl. Extend. Last time slow. And extend up to tempo. Curl. Extend. Curl. Extend. Good. For four. Three. Two. Keep your knee bent. Little pulse up. Lift. 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 You should do that little burn right here. Making sure your base knee is still bent. Whoop. Lose my balance. Stay lifted. Last change. Extend your leg. Slow circle back. Slow circle. Slow. Keep the rest of your body still. Resist the urge to circle your hips. But just move your leg. Two more. Circle and circle. Release. Shake it off. Ooh, give it a jiggle. Let's do the other side. Heels together, toes apart, feet in a small V. Bend your knees. Tuck your tailbone slightly under. Extend your opposite leg. For me, it's my left. Left, your right. Retuck your tailbone. Back diagonal. Lift and lower. Lift, lower. Notice that it's not that small. I'm not letting it move the rest of my body, but I'm just lifting, lowering. Lift, lower. And I'll give you a little side angle. Lift, lower. Again, trying not to put all of your weight into your Swiffer or prop, but staying lifted. For three, two, keep your leg lifted, little pulse up, little lift, lift. Lift, squeeze, squeeze, squeeze that little glute. and energy in your foot, pointed or flexed, option up to you. Lift, lift, relax your shoulders, keep breathing, pulling your navel in and up for 8, 6, 4, 3, flex your foot if you haven't already, bend for 2, extend for 2, bend and extend, re-bend your base leg if it's extended, re-tuck your tailbone under if you've lost that. You want to think about wideness in your low back. If you arch your back, it'll hurt here later, so tuck, 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 engage your core. Let's bring this up to tempo. Curl, extend, curl, extend. Really find that little squeeze for 4, 3, 2. Keep your knee bent, little pulse up. Lift, lift. We have one more change. You've got this, keep breathing. For 8, 6, 4, 3, 2. Extend your legs, so circle back. Slow. Keep it slow, stabilize through your hips and your base leg for 4, 3, 2, and 1. Shake it off. All right, moving on to the floor. We'll find all fours, wrists under shoulders, knees under hips. Extend your right leg directly behind you. Tuck your tailbone slightly under. Lift your right leg up and lower. Lift and lower. If this bothers your wrists, you have a few options. You can come to a fist. You can come to your forearms. Or you can pull the mat back a time or two and let your wrist kind of like hang off the edge. So whatever you'd like to do here, you'll keep your right leg up, little pulse up, little lift, lift. Make sure you're breathing, y'all know. For 8, 6, 4, 3, you'll bend and extend. Bend, extend. Beautiful, y'all. Keep your right knee lifted. It'll want to sneak down. Mine definitely does. You have 2 more. Keep your right knee bent. Little pulse up. Lift. 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 You have 8, 6, 4, 3. You'll tuck your right knee and lift. Tuck. Lift. Try to keep both sides of your body still. This is wiggling. You have 4, 3, 2. Keep your right leg lifted. Pulse once again. Option to press into your right palm and lift your left arm up however you want, whatever you need. Bog it out if you want. Woo. Find that little squeeze. You've got it for 8, 6, 4, 3, 2, and release. All right, other side. Wrists under shoulders, knees under hips. Extend your left leg behind you. Tuck your tailbone slightly under. Lift your left leg up and lift. Lift, lower. Starting long, starting strong. Again, finding the option that works best for you, for your wrist, if you need to come down to your forearms, that's always an option. Keep your leg lifted, little pulse up. Lift, lift. Deep, slow breaths will help you. Inhale and exhale. For 8, 6, 4, 3, bend, extend, bend, extend. Try to keep your knee lifted.
firing up your hamstrings. And curl. For four, three, two. Keep your knee bent, little pulse up. Lift, lift. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze your left glute. Breathe through it. We only have two more changes in eight, seven, six, five, four, three. Tuck your knee and lift. Tuck, lift. Keep breathing. We're almost there. Tuck and lift. Lift. Really stabilize both sides of your body. For four, three, two. Keep your leg lifted, little pulse. This is it. Option to press into your left palm and reach your right arm however you want. Dance it out. Do what you need. For four, three, two, and one. Release. Press your hips back to your heels. Find a child's pose. Rest. Walk your hands over to the left. Press into your right hip. Give it a little wiggle. And other side. Press into your left hip. Wiggle. Back to center. Take some breaths. Alright, abs, and then we stretch. Swing your legs in front of you. Plant your feet parallel hip-width distance, hands behind your thighs to start. Starting with a really long spine, you'll start by tucking your tailbone, tuck, and then lift all the way to seated. Tuck, and lift. We're starting small. I want you to imagine that there's a little ice cream scoop out in your low core. Relax your shoulders down your back. It's really easy to let them contract forward, but chest stays wide. And lift. Lower. Lift. Two more. Lower. Lift. Last one. Keep your scoop. Little lower. Lift. Lower. Lift. If you want a little more, you can reach your arms forward and above your head if you want even more. Do what feels good to you. For four, three, two, and one. Bring your elbows behind you, hands towards your hips. Tuck your tailbone under. Lift your right leg and lower. Lift your left. So it's pretty chill to start off with, keeping your shoulders away from your ears. Use your low core to lift. It'll get harder, I promise. Go four, three, two. Lift both of your legs. Now tap down, lift, tap, lift. Keep pulling your navel in towards your spine. Breathe as you move. For four, three, two. Lower both legs down, down. For two, lift. For two, only go as far as you can. That might not mean your heels touch the ground. Lower and lift. Lower and lift. Good. Turn your legs out, little frog position, and press your legs out and in. Press. 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 First four, three, two, and one. Release. Little rock side to side. Alright. Plant your feet. You'll bring one foot on top of your other knee and fall over to the side. Your hand is behind your head. Top hand reaches towards the legs. You'll lift and lower. Get into your obliques. Lift, lower. Lift, lift. Breathe into it. Exhale to lift. For four, three, two. Stay lifted, little pulse up. Little lift, lift, lift. For eight, six, four, three, two, and one. I'll turn around to face you. You can just switch to one side or the other. Same position, foot on knee, hand is under your head. Fingertip faces your feet. Lift, lower. Lift, lower. Breathe. Using your oblique to lift you. Trying to lift your bottom shoulder up off the floor. For four, three, two. Stay lifted, little palms up. Lift. Lift. Almost there. Woo. For eight, six, four, three, two, and one. Release. Roll onto your back. Hands down by your sides. Lift your legs up to the sky. Lower your right leg. Lift, lower your left. If you want more, you can tuck your chin, lift your shoulders, and hover your arms. When you're ready, you can add a little speed. Pull your navel in towards your spine, pressing your low back down into the mat. For four, three, two. Keep your legs up, flex your feet, arms up, little pulse. Lift, lift. Feeling energy coming out of your heels. If you need, you can always soften your knees. Pull your navel in, exhale every time you lift. We're almost there, y'all. For eight, six, four, three, pull your knees in, little rest, little rock. All right, lift and reach your arms legs long and pull back in. Reach and pull. Reach and pull. Take your time. You can speed it up if you'd like. As long as you're breathing and finding length. That's what I want. Couple more. I lied, two more. Reach and in. Last one, hold for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, release. Little rock side to side. We've made it to our stretch, so let's get into it. Let's stay folded back. You have the option to either plant your left foot or extend your left leg long, pulling your right knee into your chest. Give it a little wiggle. Good. Extend your right leg up, either grabbing onto behind your calf, your thigh, whatever you need, just try to avoid the knee. Breathe into it. Good. And then grabbing the inside part of your leg, draw your right leg out to the side. Try to keep your left hip down on the floor. good. And then back to the center, draw your left leg slightly over to the left. And then if you want, add a little sickle to your left foot. Find a little extra stretch in your IT band right here. Back to center. One last gentle pull towards your face. And release. Other side. Left knee in. Again, you can either plant your right foot or extend. Give it a little rock. Do you love me? Grab me in your arms. Extend your left leg, either grabbing onto your calf or behind your thigh or your ankle or your foot, wherever you're at today. Grabbing the inside of your leg, draw gently over to the left, keeping your right hip down on the floor. And then, whoop! Back to center, grabbing the outside of your left leg and draw it slightly over to the left. Option to sickle your foot to add a little, all right, down that goes to add a little stretch on your IT band. Back to center, one last gentle pull towards your face and release. Pull your knees into your chest, hands behind your knees. Rock yourself up to seated. Swing your feet back behind you. Tuck your toes, extend your legs, find a forward fold. And then heel toe your feet wider than your mat. I'll face you. And just find whatever release feels good here. You can nod your head yes, shake no. Heel-toe your feet underneath your hips. Bend your knees, drop your tailbone, roll yourself up to standing, restacking your spine. Your head is the last to lift. Inhale, reach your arms up. Exhale, down. Inhale, lift. And down. Inhale, lift your shoulders to your ears. Exhale, let them drop. Two more. Inhale, lift. Drop. Last one. Inhale, lift. Drop. Awesome. Thank you so much for using my Barre video. Again, if you have any questions, feel free to comment, DM, message in any way, shape, or form via Instagram or YouTube. Again, if you are able to and if you feel that you'd like to, feel free to donate via my Venmo at Dancer Kyla, which is also my username on Instagram, Dancer Kyla. Thank you.